If I started learning UX now, I'd do this. Let me break this process down and tell you 13 things you can do to maximize your chance of success in this highly competitive field of UX design. Hi, I'm Aliana. I'm a formal designer at eBay Ads, and now I teach design at Fast Track UX. The first phase is learning. You can choose a certificate course, a bootcamp, or even self-study. Before anything else, start learning UI design. And you might ask, what if I want to become a UX designer, not a UI designer? Shouldn't I take a UX design course first? This is a common misconception. To be able to design great user experience, UI design is the foundation. And also don't get too committed with that UX designer title. Web design, UI design, UX design, interaction design, these titles are whatever your company wants to name their designers. And most tech companies these days are preferring the title product designers over UX designers. So just letting you know, to learn Figma, I first suggest you to create a wireframe of a product you use. A wireframe is a simple outline of a digital product. At this stage, you don't have to align anything or even include color. And you only need to use two tools in Figma to create any wireframe. Rectangles to represent shapes and text to represent text. For example, here's a wireframe of YouTube desktop, created only using rectangles and text in Figma. Practice this with a few other products as well, and you'll get a sense of how to quickly and cheaply represent ideas. Next, move into high fidelity mockups. At this stage, try to trace the product down to the nearest pixel. Let the OCD inside you take over. This will take more time and force you to explore more tools in Figma, like the alignment tool at the top right of Figma. I suggest you to place the screenshot of the product in one frame and then your work in another frame, and then play the prototype. Go left and right to check the difference. If there's not a lot of differences, then good job. By tracing existing products, you will learn so much about UI design, and you will also discover a lot of tricks yourself, like how to size elements, how to choose color, what gap to use between these cards. If you skip this step and jump right into learning UX design, then your design won't match the vision you had in mind, because this is how you develop a sense of UI design. During this step, you also need to learn how to create prototypes in Figma. This will require you to connect multiple screens with interactions to represent how a feature flow works. And you need to learn how to use components in Figma, auto layout, and design systems. Design system, however, is not a tool in Figma. It is something you need to learn to use. I'll include all these concepts and free tutorials to most of these concepts in the PDF in the description. Next, you can learn user experience UX design. I would say study the double diamond process and research about three methods for each step. Here's a crucial part. Whatever you learn from a UX design course might not directly translate to how things are done in the real world. So learn these concepts and methods, but do not consider them as the absolute right answer. There is no right answer in UX design. For example, in the real world, the first diamond, which includes the discover and define stage, are often led by leaderships, product managers, or your client. So how can you as a UX designer get a seat at the table and discuss best UX design practices with business stakeholders? You need to get real-world client experiences to understand things like this. I cover a lot of these real-world scenarios in my course, Fast Track UX. Feel free to check it out. And when you are learning UX design, you will also start a few personal projects. This is when the next point comes in handy. The third area to learn is product design. UX design is broader than UI design, and product design is even broader. If you've worked in business or have started a business before, then good news, your business sense will come in so handy here. Basically, you need to understand how to think from a business perspective. A lot of people I see make the mistake of building a project that's like building an entire e-commerce app, an entire ride-sharing app. If you can compete with Amazon or Uber, you shall be hiring people, not into looking for jobs. So it's really important to choose a project that makes business sense, like adding a new feature to an existing product, and make sure there's a clear market need in the project you design. To learn this, I suggest you to read the book Million Dollar Weekend, or consider taking a short business, entrepreneurship, or product management course. And also, ChatGPT can be your best friend when it comes to doing a quick top-down or bottom-up annual revenue estimation of the project you want to create. Another key to success in the learning phase is accountability. If you enroll to a course or a bootcamp, then that helps to keep you accountable. If not, it's still okay, there's a lot of free online resources these days. But keep in mind that platforms that are free usually aren't really designed for focused learning. You might start your day by following a few UX design tutorials, but soon find yourself looking at a series of videos about Blackpink. So if you want to self-study UX design, I suggest you to find two accountability partners, set up goals in a spreadsheet, and then in each meeting go over what you learned, what you did well, what you didn't do well. In this case, even if you don't feel like showing up for yourself, you at least have a little bit more push because you need to show up for your accountability partners as well. For this learning phase, here are a few common mistakes I see. The first one is only learning UX design and not learning enough about UI design or product design. The second mistake I see is choosing a personal project with a huge scope, like designing an entire app by yourself. The third common mistake I see is taking the UX design process a little bit too serious, when in fact, the process is really flexible, and if you have multiple projects, then no two projects should look the same. And number four is having no accountability structure, then you will have to heavily rely on internal motivation. And it's very easy to stop in the middle and give up. Now let's talk about the exciting progress of moving from just a few personal projects to getting your first client project. You might think it's all about having a perfect portfolio. From thousands of my connections and my students, I found that networking is actually the most important thing here. I've almost never seen a case where someone got their first project by applying on LinkedIn with a portfolio and a resume. Even if they did secure a job by applying online, it's more often that they did it through an exclusive community, like jobs opening for their school's alumni. I myself got many of my first few client projects through networking. I volunteered as an event photographer in Silicon Valley to as many tech events as possible, and then I met people and clients through there. If you think you're an introvert, or if you feel like you don't have a good network, leave that fixed mindset behind and embrace a growth mindset. Read this book, Never Eat Alone by Keith Ferrazzi. Networking is a skill that you can acquire. You have the power to grow your network. And in this era of content economy, building a personal brand can also help. It takes a lot of work, but it's really rewarding in the long run. And even if you pivot away from UX design, this personal branding skill set can still serve you well. One common misconception about personal branding is that you have to have some sort of achievement so that you can show off online. That is not the case. No, no, no. It is not about posting on LinkedIn and saying things like, I am thrilled to announce that I just got this job at blah, blah, blah. It is actually about embracing your past experiences and sharing your failures and success stories and your learnings and package them into something that helps other people. And to learn more about this, read this book, The Art and Business of Online Writing. Another thing that really helps to get you a client project is pitching and sales skill. I didn't grow up with a good example of what sales really is. When I was little, most sales are actually scams. So today, I have to work really hard in my mindset and get rid of the trust issue that no longer serves me and understand that sales is about helping people. Here's my genuine tip. If you want to offer your design service to your friend, your family member, or a connection of yours, focus on how to help them. Focus on their product. Don't spend most of your effort talking about your story and how you are desperate for a client opportunity. And if you want to learn more about sales, practicing is the best thing, but if you want to read a book, you can read Ninja Selling. And another thing that I highly recommend you to do is to analyze and leverage your unfair advantages. We all have very different sets of unfair advantages, but we often overlook them because they might be similar to our connections unfair advantages, or we just take it as granted. For example, when I was at Minerva University, we had so many partnerships with good companies to work on these civic projects, like internship roles. I didn't really do so many of them because I felt like everyone around me is doing those, so it's probably not that special. I was wrong. The second I graduated, I was like, why did I not do it? And where's my student discount? And why did I not ask my professor more questions? I paid for it. Similarly, if you're working now, the minute you return to school, you'll be like, where's my freedom? Where's my time? And where's my money? So, read The Unfair Advantage to understand this better and use your unfair advantages. Many people get stuck in this client project phase and never really got a client project because they thought that after completing a certificate, they will just get a job at Google. That is not the case. My friend who now studies at a medical school literally need to study nonstop since kindergarten to 30 years old to get a well-paid job as a doctor. So if you think you can spend 3 months and get a certificate and get a well-paid job at Google, let me know about that good deal, okay? I don't mind working 3 full-time jobs at the same time. And during this client project phase, I've also seen people starting a one-person agency. This can also help you a lot. It might make you feel more proud of your work, make you understand more about business, and you might even hire other people to work with you. And later on when you're applying for jobs, even if you have a few months without client project, you can still state that you are working for your agency. And next comes the phase of getting a well-paid UX design job. There are a few things you can do, and I will call all of them professional packaging. Think of yourself like a designer bag. If you're a designer bag, you need to build yourself a designer bag package. You cannot wrap yourself in the black garbage bag and be like, I'm Louis Vuitton. And by the way, I've seen a lot of people, they've directly unlocked a senior position as a UX designer after doing a few client projects or working on their agency. One of my students even unlocked a lead designer position. So proud of her. So the first thing you can do about professional packaging is your resume. I'm not a recruiter, so I'm not the best person to learn how to write a resume, but here's a few tips. Add a lot of numbers, don't be too vague, and there's no need to make the resume overly stylish. I have a video on how to write a killer UX design resume, and I will include that in the PDF in the description. You need to work on your portfolio. This is the most important thing at this step. Now when I recruit a UX designer, I only look for 2 things. The first is their LinkedIn profile, and the second is their portfolio. Portfolio being the most important part. My most updated portfolio tutorial is also included in the PDF. But you cannot skip a lot of steps and directly build a portfolio, especially not a good one. If you're rushing through the process, jumping through a lot of steps, then you'll realize that it's going to be very difficult to build a portfolio that fits your skill set. I see a lot of people with a portfolio that's like a list of what they've done, but a better portfolio will be something that fits the skill set. And you can also leverage referrals at this step. Many companies will prioritize people that are referred by people that are already working in their company. Here's what you need to know about referrals. If you actually get into that position, then the person who referred you will actually get a bonus from their company. So it is a win-win, and hence, do not be shy. Go out there and meet people, do those coffee chats. And finally, just exposure. Don't just apply on LinkedIn. I find a lot of LinkedIn positions are often heavily advertised, so most people see similar things. Feel free to try platforms like Indeed and just must apply. I remember I used to apply for one role every 2 minutes, but I set a healthy boundary, like about 1 hour per day for myself, so I don't become a robot. So definitely maximize your chance by applying more. In the beginning of this video, I mentioned that I will share 13 points. So what is the 13th point? This is the most important thing to me, and I think it comes before anything else. Find a reason behind your passion. Becoming a UX designer is not a short-term investment. It is a lifelong investment. Most people I talk to say that they want to become a UX designer because it's highly paid, you don't have to work long hours, and you don't have to code. But even with all these reasonings, you may still find yourself getting demotivated in the process because it is not easy. When I was 15 years old, I left China to study in Canada, which I now returned. And before I left China, I bought my grandmother an iPad so that I can FaceTime her. The moment I landed in Canada and FaceTime her for the first time, I saw her face light up. Mine as well. That's the kind of joy that can hardly be described. It was so powerful, and at that moment, I really felt how technology, when designed well, can change people's life for the better. And since then, my passion has always been to recreate that moment to as many people as possible. It has been over 10 years since I left my home country, and I'm still FaceTiming my grandmother every single day for more than 10 years. Every day I see her, I'm being reminded why I started this at the first place. When your drive comes from love, whether the next wave of technology is on AI, blockchain, brain computer interface, spatial design, you just have something deeper down that tells you it's all the same to recreate the moment I first FaceTimed my grandmother, using as many ways as possible. And even if your career footsteps turn out to be a little bit different from what you expected, you will still love it, and you will have all it takes to create the future you envision. As I said, if you want a PDF for more links, more resources, I've put it in the description. You need to enter zero to get it for free. Just enter zero. There's no need to pay me. This is the price feature is something I cannot turn off because of course from the product perspective, it won't benefit Gumroad. And if you like this video, you will also like this video. I will see you in this video. My name is Aliana. Learning design is a long journey, but it is so fulfilling and please have fun during it. And if new ideas and new opportunities come your way, I say just do it. Bye bye, cheers.